Welcome back, students. We are going to see today chapter 4, quadratic equation. So before entering into the quadratic equation, we see what is quadratic polynomial. So you would have studied in 9th standard, a quadratic polynomial is a polynomial whose highest power of the variable should be 2. So to find the zeros of the polynomial, you will equate this polynomial to 0. So what will happen if you equate this polynomial to 0? This becomes a quadratic equation. So now coming to the quadratic equation definition. Quadratic equation is in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers and a is not equal to 0. In the first exercise of quadratic equation, we are going to see two types of questions given. The first question is, check whether it is a quadratic equation. So he will be giving an expression on both sides. We want to expand and find whether it is in a quadratic equation. Second one, he will give the situation. We want to make that situation in the form of a quadratic equation. That is, framing the situation into a quadratic equation. Let us see what is in exercise 4.1. Exercise 4.1, the first problem, check whether the following are in quadratic equation. So the first problem, x plus 1 the whole square is equal to 2 into x minus 3. So we want to expand my LHS and RHS. We are going to prove whether it is in a quadratic form. So we will see the left hand side now, x plus 1 the whole square. So since it is given as a whole square, we are using the algebraic identity formula to expand this. So you will have x squared plus 2x plus 1 square. So which is equal to, now expanding my right hand side, 2 into x, 2x, 2 into minus 3, 6. Now shifting all my right hand side terms to the left hand side, I will get x squared plus 2x plus 1 minus 2x plus 6 is equal to 0. Now we are going to simplify here. Plus 2x minus 2x gets cancelled. So x squared plus 1 plus 6, it becomes 7, which is equal to 0. So this equation has a power 2 here. So it is in quadratic equation. Third subdivision. The problem is x minus 2 into x plus 1 is equal to x minus 1 into x plus 3. So here I am going to simplify my left hand side and simplify my right hand side to prove whether it is in quadratic equation. Now coming to our LHS, just we will simplify now. X squared minus 2x plus 6 minus 2, which is equal to x squared plus 3x minus 1x minus of 3. So when you simplify, you will get x squared minus 2x plus 6, it becomes minus x minus 2, which is equal to x squared, simplify, 2x minus 3. Now shifting my right hand side terms to the left hand side, x squared minus x minus 2 minus x squared plus 2x becomes minus 2x, minus 3 becomes plus 3 is equal to 0. So plus x squared minus x squared gets cancelled, minus 2x minus x becomes minus 3x, minus 2 plus 3 becomes plus 1, which is equal to 0. Since your polynomial whose x variable has a power 1, it is not in a quadratic. Sixth subdivision, x squared plus 3x plus 1 is equal to x minus 2 the whole square. So we are going to simplify on both sides. Since this left hand side is already in expanded form, we will just simplify the right hand side now. So you will write x squared is equal to, so a minus b the whole square. So a squared minus of 2 into a into b, so it becomes minus 4x plus b squared. Bringing all the right hand side terms to the left hand side, I will get x squared plus 3x plus 1. So plus x squared minus x squared. So minus 4x becomes plus 4x minus plus 4 becomes minus 4, which is equal to 0. Now plus x squared minus x squared gets cancelled. Plus 3x plus 4x, it becomes plus 7x plus 1 minus 4, so it becomes minus 3, which is equal to 0. Since your variable has a power 1, so it is not a quadratic equation. So it does not belong to the quadratic equation. Eighth subdivision, x cube minus 4x squared minus x plus 1 is equal to x minus 2 the whole cube. Since your left hand side is in expanded form, we are going to expand the right hand side. The right hand side, it's given x minus 2 the whole power 3, that is whole cube. We are going to use our identity formula, a minus b the whole cube is equal to a cube minus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared minus b cube. So expanding using this identity, x minus 2 the whole power 3 is equal to x cube minus 3x squared into 2 plus 3x into 2 squared minus of 2 cube. So you will have x cube minus 6x squared plus 12x minus 8. So we are going to use this expanded form in my right hand side. Left hand side is x cube minus 4x squared minus 8th subdivision, x cube minus 4x squared minus x plus 1. See, already we have expanded using the identity. We got x cube minus of 6x squared plus 12x minus 8. So bringing all the right hand side to the left hand side, I will get x cube minus 4x squared minus x plus 1. Minus x cube becomes plus x cube becomes minus x cube. So minus 6x squared becomes plus 6x squared plus 12x minus 12x minus 8 plus 8 is equal to 0. So x cube plus x cube minus x cube gets cancelled. 4x squared minus 4x squared plus 6x squared, we will get 2x squared minus x minus 12x is equal to minus 13x plus 1 plus 8 comes plus 9 is equal to 0. Since this equation has a variable highest power is 2, we call this as a quadratic equation. So it is in quadratic equation form. Second problem, represent the following situation in the form of a quadratic equation. So the first problem he has given, area of a rectangular plot is 328 meters square. The length of the plot is 1 more than twice its breadth. Frame the situation in quadratic equation form. So we are going to bring this statement in the form of a quadratic equation. So here it's given that the length is compared to the breadth. So the length is given as 1 more than twice its breadth. So we are going to take my breadth as x. So assume that let the breadth be x meters. So the length of the rectangular plot will be, so 1 more than twice its breadth. So twice is 2 times of x, 1 more than is plus 1. So length is equal to 2x plus 1. Given that area of a rectangular plot is 328. So area of the rectangle is, area of the rectangular plot is equal to L into B. So he has given that the area is 328, which is equal to L into B. So L is 2x plus 1, B is x. So 328 is equal to, multiplying here, x into 2x, 2x squared, x into 1 plus x. So bringing 328 to the other side, it becomes 2x squared plus x minus 328 is equal to 0. So here you have this equation whose variable x is of the power 2, highest power 2. So I got this situation in the form of a quadratic equation. Now second subdivision of second problem. The product of two consecutive positive integers is 306. Frame it in quadratic equation form. So I want to bring this situation in terms of a quadratic equation. So he has given that product of two consecutive positive integers. So let us write. Let us take two consecutive positive integers as x and x plus 1. So in the problem it is given the product of two consecutive positive integers is equal to 306. So according to the problem, the product of two consecutive positive integers is equal to 306. So multiplying here x into x, x squared, x plus 1 is x, which is equal to 306. Bringing this 306 to the other side, x squared plus x minus 306 is equal to 0. So I got the situation in terms of quadratic equation. Fourth problem, fourth subdivision of second problem. A train travels a distance of 480 km at a uniform speed. If the speed had 8 km per hour less, then it would have taken 3 hours more to cover the same distance. We are going to frame this situation in the quadratic equation form. So before entering into it, we are going to use the concept time is equal to distance by speed. We are going to use a concept in this problem. So coming to the problem, assume that the uniform speed be x kilometer per hour. So time taken is t, which is equal to distance is 480, speed is x kilometer per hour. So he has given that if the speed is 8 kilometer less, so the time taken would be longer, that is along with this time 3 hours more. So time taken will be 3 hours more than the normal time if its speed is decreased by 8 km per hour than my usual speed. So now we are going to substitute the value of t here in this equation, where t is 480 by x plus 3, which is equal to 480 by x minus 8. So in this case, I am substituting the value of t as 480 by x in the equation. So now coming to this problem, we are going to bring the right hand side to the left hand side. 480 by x minus 480 by x minus 8, and bringing the 3 left hand side, 3 to the right hand side. So plus 3 becomes minus 3. Now here in both the cases you have 480 as common. So I am going to take 480 as commonly outside. I will have 1 by x minus of 1 by x minus 8 is equal to minus 3. So now 480 I am going to take to the other side. So it comes under division here on your right hand side. 1 by x minus of 1 by x minus 8, which is equal to minus 3 by 480, which I further simplify, I will get minus 1 by 160. Now taking LCM, you will get x into x minus 8. So x is here, so multiply x minus 8 with the denominator and the numerator. So I get x minus 8 minus of x minus 8 is here, so multiply x with the numerator and denominator becomes minus x is equal to 1 by 160. So plus x minus x gets cancelled. You will be having minus 8 by x into x minus 8, which is equal to minus 1 by 160. So cancelling minus sign on both sides and cross multiplying, you will get 8 into 160, which is equal to x into x minus 8. So this becomes 1280, which is equal to x squared minus of 8x, which further you will get x squared minus 8x minus of 1280 is equal to 0. So I bought the situation in the terms of a quadratic equation where whose variable is of the highest power 2. So hence I represented the situation in the form of a quadratic equation. Now let us see in the second session of the class.